Hello and welcome to this episode of Raxio Hour. Happy New Month. Congratulations on yet another step towards concluding 2020. As the year comes to a close, it is vital for business to take stock, review their performance, and plan ahead for the new year. Wondering what 2021 will bring and how SMEs and enterprises can be ready? Our General Manager, Mr. James Piaruhanga, took time to share the top ICT business needs for the year 2021. Take a look and take some notes too.
Hi guys, my name is James Piaruhanga. I'm the General Manager for Raxio Data Center Uganda. Would you believe the year is actually over? It's mind-blowing. It's unbelievable. November is here. 1 month to the end of the year. We know how December is, and this year is a year where we really need to enjoy and celebrate just being alive. And what a year it has been. I think 2020, by far, the most unpredictable year. I didn't think it was going this way. I don't think you thought it was going this way. But hey, you never know what nature presents. And when the going gets tough, the tough get going. So I guess this is the time to kind of really think about 2021. Before we finish 2020, and if anything we learned is that we need to prepare well in advance. So, if we reflect about 2020, what happened in the world of business, in the world of life as we know it? I guess candidate number one, COVID-19, threw a spanner in the works. Everything was unpredictable. Work from home, study from home, entertainment was cut out. We still had to basically entertain ourselves at home. We couldn't see our friends and family. It was complete mayhem. But somehow we had to stay living, we had to keep our businesses open, and it really forced us to think about how better we could do this. What else? Another interesting variable. Fires. Somehow there was fire everywhere. I'm not sure if there's any relation to COVID or not, but there was a lot of fires and affecting a lot of enterprises that were carrying a lot of data. We also saw a significant rise in water levels, causing floods in some areas, and becoming a threat to some businesses, especially like businesses that are near the lake or near rivers, and something that we really hadn't planned for. We saw the levels grow at the highest level in the history of Lake Victoria, for example. And come on 2021, we have political season getting into the limelight as well. Yes, we had a bit of political season in 2020 with nominations and some of the primaries, but we have presidential elections, and you know they usually come with a bit of drama here and there. And of course, COVID will still be around. Who knows, the weather doesn't seem to be changing easily. It's time to plan for 2021. We can't be caught pants down like we were in 2020. So I have some little advice to share with SMEs and enterprises. I'll start with the SMEs. I believe that to be prepared better for 2021, you need to focus on a couple of things. One is, are you able to work on the move? Two, are you able to leverage cloud services or shared infrastructure somewhere so that you don't have to invest in your own infrastructure? You need to use your capital for the right reasons. Three, are you able to utilize skills that are available elsewhere without you trying to increase your staff costs by trying to find specialized individuals? Think about how you can compete in the market with SMEs, and how can you compete with some of the enterprise market depending on the services you offer. This is the time to consider looking at getting services, for example, from a data center, from resellers who can sell you bite-sized packages without you having to spend so much money in building your own infrastructure or taking up huge capacities. This is the time to think about buying services from cloud providers that are already sitting in environments that can give you predictable behavior for your IT systems. Enterprises, on this, you have a different need, you've got different requirements, and you have different challenges. Previously, you've been concentrating a lot on in-house data centers, in-house huge teams, in-house applications. You don't really need to do all these different things. This is a time to reduce your operational cost as well, and it's time to think about how do you use data analytics to make good business decisions. How can you outsource services that are not critical to your core business and concentrate on generating revenues to increase your top line and reducing on your operational cost? So many people are trying to figure out how to deal with 2021. I would really, really suggest that you think through where your efficiencies are and where your strengths are. Put your focus on where your key strengths are, and you can leave the weak areas for people who specialize in them. Other than that, I want to wish you a happy end of 2020, an early, a great 2021 beginning, and most importantly, please stay safe and stay alive.
Thanks for your insights, James. Also, as the year nears completion, we are happy to report that we are in the final stages of construction at Uganda's first Tier 3 and truly carrier-neutral data center facility. Here's a look at our latest drone footage that captures a stunning aerial view of the world-class facility taking shape in the Namanve Industrial Park. Thanks for watching. For more updates, check out our social media platforms, that is, at RaxioUG on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and LinkedIn. Until next time, stay safe.